Our breath is actually a mixture of many gases. What is important that some of these gases might be really important for our health. I'm Gerard Wysocki and I'm assistant professor in electrical engineering department at Princeton University. Why nitric oxide is important? It's probably because of its important function of being a signaling molecule in the cardiovascular system. It takes a lot of different pathways through our body. For example, if you have inflammation in your body, this inflammation, you will be producing nitric oxide that will be detectable in a gas phase. We use lasers to perform optical spectroscopy. This is a method that gives you a very high specificity, and we basically see only nitric oxide and we don't see many other species. Those millions of species that you can find in your breath are invisible to our analyzer, and that's the advantage. If you put nitric oxide in magnetic field, you align those molecules in the space, and then when they interact with laser light, they do it slightly different than any other molecule in that mixture. In our breath, we usually observe anything between single parts per billion levels to maybe 100 parts per billion levels for people who produce a lot of NO due to inflammation. People with asthma usually produce higher levels. And the analyzer that you will be using to detect it has to be very sensitive in order to look at such a small minute amount of nitric oxide in the breath. That's the main difficulty in measuring important molecules in breath. The optical configuration is very simple. We have three major elements: the laser, a gas cell between two polarizers, and a photodetector. In this kind of instrumentation, in order to improve sensitivity, we have to suppress the noise. And we came up with a new method of suppressing the noise by modulating the laser at really high frequencies, where the noise is much lower, and then subsequent demodulation at that high frequency allows us to reach fundamental quantum noise levels, which allows to perform this measurement at really high sensitivities. My graduate student Ying Wang is currently working with Dr. Raed Dweik from Cleveland Clinic on application of our analyzer to detection of nitric oxide in breath, urine, and blood samples. In the clinical environment, research that is currently ongoing requires this type of analyzers to look at nitric oxide in many different forms. We are the first to actually be able to measure nitric oxide isotopes in breath, urine, and blood samples simultaneously. At this particular moment, I think this technology is ready for research in a clinical environment. The next stage will be to improve the compactness, improve the overall easiness of use, and use it in the doctor's office. I think it would be great if you go to the doctor's office and he tells you what's good or bad about your body to make little adjustments in the next couple of months and maybe come back and take another test without losing a drop of your blood.